In this video, we'll get to the most exciting thing in WordPress and see how you actually write a post. I'm going to show you how to write a post, but it works exactly the same for pages, so no worries there. The only differences are in the options in the sidebar, which we'll explore in the screencast about the sidebar in the same module. To start writing, click on Posts and then the Add New button. You'll end up on a screen that gives you a whole lot of options. Especially if you've already installed some plugins, they may occupy some space as well. But let's ignore all of these things and focus on the big block of white space in the middle. That's where you're going to write your post. The first thing you need to do is already laid out for you. Add a title. Enter the title of the post you want to create, and in our case, that's Top Tourist Attractions in Istanbul. And now, you're going to have to make the first of many decisions, whether to start writing or use a block. So what are blocks? Well, everything you do in the post editor is divided up into a block. In its simplest form, a block can be a paragraph. A block can be a heading as well, but a block can be an image with a caption or video or all kinds of interesting things. We're going to go into these interesting things more in detail in a later screencast. For now, let's first write a little introduction to the article. For example, I will put this text. Now, I want this introduction to be in italics. To do that, I simply double-click on the text to select it and click the I right above the text. I can also put the text in bold. You can also align the text left, center, or right, as you see here. Or you can add a link to a part of your text. On the far left, you can also transform the block into another type. Like if I'd want to start with a quotation, I could use the quote block here and transform the introduction into a quote. But I don't want to do that actually, so let's change it back to a simple paragraph. There's also a More Options option on the far right. This allows you to duplicate the block, insert another block before or after this block, and to edit the block as HTML if you want to do some fancy HTML stuff. You probably won't need to use these options very often. Once you've finished your introduction, simply press Enter and you'll automatically create a new block. Now, I want to discuss three hotspots in Istanbul in my article, so it makes sense to create a heading for every one of them. Headings show your readers what's coming and allow them to scan quickly to see whether the content is interesting for them. So let's create a heading for the first hotspot we're going to discuss, the Hagia Sophia. Click the little plus symbol on the left, right here, and add a heading block. As you can see, you can create an H2, H3, or H4. That's because the H1 is always the title of the page. Headings show hierarchy. So we're going to use H2 for every hotspot because all of them are equally important to our article. So let's type in Hagia Sophia here and press Enter to create another paragraph. Now, let me just copy-paste the rest of the sample article in to save us all time. If you're copy-pasting from another source, always check to see whether it all works. In this case, it works fine, so that's nice. Now, say that you want to switch around two of the paragraphs you've written because that would be better for the article. That's very easy to do. Just select the paragraph you want to move, then hover over it, and then click one of the arrows you see on the left of the block. They'll move up and down accordingly. And if you want to remove a block, just select the text and then press backspace. If you want to remove several blocks at once, you can simply select them and again press backspace. Let's just undo this and return to our original article. Okay, so now we've got a complete post with an introduction, three hotspots, and a conclusion. Of course, if I were to write a real article, it would probably be a lot longer, but this was just to illustrate how writing a post works. Once you've finished your post, you can save it as a draft here or publish it at the top right of your screen. If you publish the post, visitors on your site will be able to see and read it, so don't do this unless you're sure you feel good about the post. Before you publish, it's always smart to preview what your post looks like on your actual site. I've stuck to the basics here, but if you're doing more fancy things, which we're going to do in the upcoming screencast, you'll always want to check whether everything shows the way you want it to. To do this, you go to the top right corner of your screen and click Preview. WordPress will generate a preview of what the page will look like. And that's it. Now you are ready to start writing your first post.